This is Mission Control Houston. We want to welcome you to today's Space Station Live. It is Monday, October 28th, 2013. This is a live view inside the Space Station Flight Control Room here at the Johnson Space Center. This team here being led by Flight Director Emily Nelson this morning. Sitting beside her is Leslie Ringo, that is the CAPCOM, talking with the crew today. Of course, the main news of today is the Albert Einstein Automated Transfer Vehicle, ATV-4, that is the European cargo craft, has departed the International Space Station. That took place earlier this morning at 3:55 a.m. Central Time, as we take a look back at the video from this morning. This spacecraft had brought up more than 7 tons of food, fuel, and supplies to the station's residents as it slowly backed away from the Zvezda service module, that is the aft portion of the Russian segment of the International Space Station. Now that ATV has departed, it is packed full of trash and other items that the crew no longer needed, and it will be deorbited coming up this weekend on November 2nd. There's a couple of different deorbit burns that are planned, one at 3:36 a.m. Central Time, the other one at 6:28 a.m. Central Time, and that will signal the end of ATV-4. All of that activity this morning went according to plan. So now that Zvezda service module on the back end of the Russian segment is set up to have a Soyuz relocated over there coming up in just a few short days at the end of this week. Fyodor Yurchikhin and Luca Parmitano and Karen Nyberg will be relocating their Soyuz. That is the Soyuz that brought them up to the station back in May. It's going to serve as the ride home coming up on November the 10th here in America. They're going to relocate that from the current Rosvet module over to Zvezda to make way for the upcoming Soyuz activities that are coming up in just a couple of weeks. Also on board today, Oleg Kotov is working to tear down some of the equipment that was used for this morning's ATV activities on Zvezda. He's going to be reinstalling some equipment on that port to get it set up for that upcoming Soyuz relocation. Also on board, Mike Hopkins, the NASA flight engineer, is taking part in the spinal ultrasound experiment today. This is one of the onboard research activities. He uses ultrasound technology to take measurements of the crew members' spines. The goal of the experiment is to help determine and to help better predict what kind of changes happen to the spinal cord whenever the crews are up on orbit. They tend to get a little bit taller than what they are here on the planet. Crews have seen up to a 3% increase in height while in space, which doesn't sound like a whole lot, but it can cause some lower back pain and other muscle issues. So what they do is try to predict exactly what causes that and to help understand how different bodies react to being up in space. So that ultrasound will be used later on today on Mike Hopkins. Hopkins also going to be taking part in some inspection of some of the spacewalk gear that's inside the station, mainly the tethers that are used to secure the astronauts to the outside of the station whenever they're outside doing a spacewalk. They do these checks of the equipment in the Quest airlock from time to time just to make sure that everything is in proper working order and ready to support future spacewalks when we get ready to do those once again. Karen Nyberg is working to install a humidifier in the cell biology experiment rack today that is in the Kibo laboratory. She'll also be working with Hopkins on the spinal ultrasound experiment as well. Of course, Nyberg, as well as Luca Parmitano and Fyodor Yurchikhin, getting ready to come home. Their time aboard the space station is rapidly coming to a close, but of course, we're going to do things a little bit out of order. Typically, what we do is have a landing and then a launch, but because of the upcoming 9-person crew on board the space station, as well as the Olympic torch that is coming up, we're going to be doing a launch first. So down now, getting ready for launch, is the upcoming crew of Mikhail Turin, Rick Mastracchio, and Koichi Wakata. They are going to be launching on November the 6th. That launch will take place as those three head up into space at 10:14 p.m. Central Time on November the 6th. Here's a look at all of our programming that's coming up as we offer live coverage of those activities. So again, launch at 10:14 p.m. Central Time. Our docking coverage will begin that night, or that morning rather, at 3:45 a.m. Central Time on November the 7th. Docking will take place at 4:31 a.m. Central Time. Hatch opening coverage will begin at 6:15 a.m. Central Time, with the actual hatch opening taking place at 6:40 a.m. Central Time. And at that point, we'll have 9 people on board the space station. That is something we have not have, that we've not had in quite a number of months and years, so it'll be exciting to see 9 people on board the space station. After that takes place, there'll be a spacewalk, and then The crew of Nyberg and Parmitano and Yurchikhin will come home. Their landing is due to take place on Sunday, November the 10th. They will physically undock from the space station at 5:26 p.m. Central Time on November the 10th. There will be a separation burn that will take place at 5:29 to back them away from the space station. The deorbit burn will take place at 7:56 p.m. Central Time with a landing at 8:50 p.m. Central Time. Of course, they're going to be landing in Kazakhstan, as is traditional. They will be outside of the southernmost city of Karaganda. And preparations are underway to get ready to support that crew as they return back home to Earth after almost 6 months up in space.